Hi, this is Freddy from Switzerland with another video, and today we're going to talk about something a little bit different. It's not going to be a video about knife, guns, or a particular useful gear. It is going to be a video about something that I haven't reviewed before, and also something that I hadn't had before. And it is also something that at the moment has a little bit of a hype going on, and you see reviews and overviews of different types and different versions of this particular thing popping up all over YouTube. And I happened to check out this particular version from the company Black Hills Precision, that is a newer startup company out of the US that builds these products in the US, and they do a pretty good job as far as I can tell. And I am of course talking about a hand spinner, and this one here is the Isotope 0.67. So a radioactive sign shaped hand spinner. First off, let's talk about the specs of it. So we have a diameter here of this spinner of 6.6 centimeters or 2.6 inches. So it's on the medium to larger end of the spinners that are available as far as I know. Since I am a knife, gun and gear channel, let's go to a little bit of a size comparison with some knives. So here we have the Isotope spinner. I'm going to put it right here. And then I have some knives that a lot of people have, so we can do a little bit of a comparison. So we have a newer knife in my collection, which is here the Spyderco Delica in the Zome Green. Here in the close position, looks like this against the Isotope spinner. And if we open it up, it looks like that. So maybe that could give you a little bit of a frame of reference for the size of the hand spinner here. And we can also get a look here at the Zome Green, which I think looks really nice. I think it really makes these Zytel scales look a little bit more substantial and a little bit more high quality, in my opinion. A review of this knife will certainly be coming up on my channel as well. And the next comparison I have for you is going to be a Victorinox Pioneer, also a very, very popular knife. Here in the close position, you can see a little bit closer in the overall size. And if I open it up, you can see it as well. This is of course the Alox version, and there are other versions available as well. It's the limited edition 2015. And the last comparison I have for you is going to be a ZT0450CF in the closed position. Looks like that. And in the open position, like this. So I hope I could give you a little frame of reference for the size of this spinner. It is my first spinner, so I'm not very experienced with this. I just wanted to check this out because I really like the design and I thought this would be very well made. It is completely made out of aluminum, and you have a button here in the middle where everything rotates around, and then you have your three prongs of the radioactive sign. And you can see that it doesn't look like aluminum here on the a radioactive sign part, and that is because it has a really nice copper vein powder coat on it that makes it look really, really interesting, really, really good looking. And that was also something that sold me on this particular spinner, because these spinners are available in a lot of different powder coats and also in a standard bead blasted aluminum. Really a lot to choose from, and also the price is quite nice. They started around $60 if I'm not mistaken, and then they go up to over 100 when you get the brass model. So in the world of full metal hand spinners, this is quite an affordable one and also a very well made one as far as I can see. So I now had this for around 2 months, and I'm quite happy with it. I play with it a lot, and it's just a nice thing to do when you're not flicking your knives, or you can't flick your knives. It's just a fun thing to do. It's certainly not something you need or you really have to rush out and buy, but if you're interested in something like that, a little fidget toy, if you always click your pen or something, this little hand spinner could be something for you. And now I'm going to show you how it spins. So there are a lot of different techniques how you could spin this spinner. I normally use my ring finger like that, and you can hear it spins. So it's not completely silent, but it's not very loud either. And I forgot to tell you, the bearings that are in this spinner are hybrid ceramic bearings. So this is, I believe, an upgrade from the most basic model that just has normal stainless steel bearings. and it should run a little bit smoother and a little bit less noisy with these hybrid ceramic bearings. So that is certainly an upgrade you should consider. And you can also see that you have the button in the middle here, that on my particular version is bead blasted, and I opted for that, but there are three different versions or three different finishes available here on this button, and you can get it bead blasted like this, then you can get it tumbled and I believe polished. So there are a lot of options to choose from here, and it really works very well. I'm quite happy with the spin time on this, even though it is just full aluminum, and you can see it also, it is also not too thick. And you can also spin it on the table right here without any problem, because the buttons protrude from the body of the spinner. So certainly a versatile spinner, and just a really nice thing to play with. So when you're getting your isotope spinner, you are getting it in a little tin. I opted to get a little different shipping because I'm here in Switzerland and I could save quite a bit on shipping. So I opted a normal cardboard packaging, but you actually would get a nice little round tin where your isotope spinner comes in, and you also are getting this little certificate with the logo of Black Hills Precision, and on the back side you can see all the information. So we have here 17th of November was the day that this was built. It was the 134th isotope spinner that they have made. Here you can see the actual name, radioactive isotope 0.67, and the maker, and also that it is made out of aluminum, the button, and also the body, so not the brass version. But I think that is a really nice thing how they executed their certificate here. Really nice idea, and I'm very happy with this spinner. This particular version cost me around 70 to 80, but I'm not quite sure. So if you're interested in one of these spinners, there are a lot of different versions, as I said. You can follow Black Hills Precision on their Facebook page, and they also have a Etsy store that is linked on their Facebook page, and they also have a Instagram account, and I will link all three of those in the description below. And I would certainly recommend to check it out if you're searching for a reasonably priced full metal spinner with a cool design from a really nice company. I really have to say, I think it's a very well built spinner. I have a lot of fun with it, and I'm glad that I picked one up. I certainly will not going to be collecting hand spinners or anything like that, but I just wanted to see how these things are, because in videos the spinning of these things really looks quite amazing, I have to say. So I'm very happy that I have my spinner now, but it certainly is going to be the only one probably. So I hope this was interesting to you, and if it is, please leave it in the comments. I really like this hand spinner, but I'm not going to bore you with a lot of more spinner reviews or something like that. I think this one is going to be my only one, but I wanted to show it here on YouTube because I think there are no videos on this spinner out until now. So that is just my opinion. Pretty nice spinner. I really like the copper vein powder coat here, and this was my review of the Black Hills Precision Radioactive Isotope Hand Spinner. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please leave any comments below. And if you want to see more videos, not on hand spinners, but on knife, guns, and gears, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day, and goodbye.